Good morning, students. In last video, we had discussed about Java variables, declaring and initializing variables, creating a new project in BlueJ, how to compile, how to execute the programs. In this video, we are going to discuss about comments, Java tokens, how to pass arguments in main, etc. in BlueJ. So let's start with comments in Java. Comments are used to explain the program or documentation of the program for others to understand what the program is intended to do. Comments are ignored by the compiler and not treated as executable part of the program. Here are two types of comments. First one, single line comments. This is preceded by double slash. For example, here written for the explain the about the registration number that unique for every student. So here registration number it tells the other users to that it should be unique for every student. Next, the multi-line comment. Each line of multi-line comment is enclosed within slash, asterisk and strict slash. Some programmers precede each enclosed line by an asterisk, but that is not necessary. Let's see the example. Here all three lines are as a comments. This is part of program but not treated as executable part of the program. Now let's see how to pass argument to the main. Arguments are the values passed to a function for processing. Let us try a simple program to see how arguments are passed to the main while running the program. Double click on my class to open it in the editor and modify the main so that it looks like as shown here. Compile the program and close the editor and run main. In the method call dialog box, mention the names of three favorite fruits as shown here and click on OK button. When we run main, we pass three arguments and the output will show like this. So in this way we can pass arguments to the main function. When we run main function, we pass three arguments, the names of the fruits like this, in double quotes, mango, apple, guava. These three values are stored in the variable str like this. Variable str will have as many cells as the number of arguments passed, and each cell stores one value according to the sequence of the arguments. Such a variable which store multiple values of same type in the sequence are called array. Here str is a string type array. The index of the values in an array is zero based, which means the first value takes the position 0, second 1, third 2, and so on. If the number of arguments in is n, then the position of the last argument in the array will be n minus 1. Here the third argument to guava is the position at guava is at position 2 in array str. Now let us understand how these values are expressed in mean. See the following lines of codes. System.out.println str of 0, System.out.println str of 1, System.out.println str of 2. In figure, you can see that each and every argument is stored in the different cells. That index number started from 0 and then 1, 2. So here the mango is stored in str of 0, apple is stored in str of 1, and guava is stored in str of 2. Every println is referring to an array str with the position of the value in it within bracket. Str 0 refers to mango, str 1 refers to apple, str 2 refers to guava. Now let's discuss about the system.out.print and system.out.println. What is the difference between these? Both are used to display message on the screen, but there is some difference. You must have seen that println and print function have been used in displaying output of our program. These are Java functions which take a value and print it on the standard output device, that is monitor. println display the given value and append a new line character also to output so that next output appears on the next line. Print function does not add. Print function does not add a new line character in the end. We know that print and println display output to a standard output device monitor. Both of these methods are defined in the in inbuilt Java object out. Out represents a standard output device or a stream of output characters. System is the Java class in which object out has been defined. Hence we access print and println methods as system.out dot print function and system.out.println respectively. In object-oriented programming language like C++ and Java, access to the feature of an object are done by the help of dot operator. You shall learn about a system class in higher classes in detail. Now let's discuss about the Java tokens, constants, and keywords. Any smallest unit in the program is called token. It may be a single letter, denoting an operator such as plus symbol for addition, any keywords such as class, int, float, string, any name or identifier of any variable, class or function such as my class, main, age, grid, any special punctuation such as semicolon used to terminate each statement, or curly bracket used to mark a block of statements, comment symbols such as double slash, slash asterisk, and asterisk slash, etc. Here the constants. What is constant in Java? Value which does not change in program is called constant. Three types of constants available in Java. First, the number constant. They are numeric and real constants like 75, 85, 78.09, 12.99, etc. Character constant. These values are single characters enclosed with single quotes like A in single quotes, L in single quotes, F in single quote, 5 HTTP, etc. Note that single digit within single quotes is also a character. Next one is string constant. The sequence of characters enclosed in the double quotes like New Delhi, Ravi Kumar, in double quotes the numbers, etc. They are string constants. Numbers enclosed within the double quotes also treated as a string. Here are some rules to create identifiers. It means it name of the variable, class, function, object. First one, identifier are case sensitive. So uppercase and lowercase letter identifier treated as different types. Identifier cannot be any reserved keyword like class, true, integer, identity, string, etc. Identifier name cannot start with number but can contain letters, underscore, dollar sign and numbers, but numbers in but not at starting, it's in middle or end. For example, string player 1 but underscore date, dollar city, etc. Identifier names cannot contain symbols or spaces. It means if you want to give a space, then use underscore, just like it, but underscore date. Now next one is Java keywords. Keywords are the building blocks of a programming language. All the words which are reserved as part of syntax of programming language are called keywords. For example, in Java, you have seen many keywords already, such as class, main, int, float, public, static, double, new, char, etc. Now next one, operators. Operators are used to process the data input to the program and to evaluate conditions. Operators are operators that process the data work upon the values through arithmetic operators. Conditions are evaluated by the help of relational and logical operators. Arithmetic operator. Arithmetic operators perform arithmetic operations on the values. These operators and their explanation are given here. Arithmetic operator returns the type of values which they are working upon. For example, here 10 plus 3.2 will return 13.2, which is a float type or double type, while 10 plus 3 will return numeric or integer value. Here is some operators, arithmetic operators, for plus sign, like for addition. For example, if the value of a is 15 and the b is 6, then a plus b will return 21. Here the minus sign for subtraction. So here, according to the given example, a minus b will return 9. Here multiplication sign, asterisk symbol, then a and b will return 90. Here division slash third division, it means a division b will return 2.5. Here the modulus symbol that is used for the remainder, a mod b, it means 15 mod 6 will return 3. Now the relational operators. Relational or comparison operator compare two operands and return true or false. Relational operators are in Java summarized here. First, smaller than. Here's the example. If the A is 2 and B is 5, then A is less than B, you return true. Yes, 2 is less than 5. It's a true. Rational operator always returns value in true and false. So next one, greater than. A greater than B will return false because the A 2 is not greater than 5. Less than equal to is smaller or equal to. It means A is less than equal to B. Yes, it's not equal but less than. Now greater than equal to, A greater than equal to B, false. Equal to. Here it is used if you want to compare the equality of the number, then you have to use the double equal symbol. Because a single equal symbol is used to assign a value. Here A equal B, no. Because 2 is not equal to 5. It's a false. Here not is not equal. That's A not equal to B is true. Here, 2 is not equal to 5. Java also provides the unary and binary operators. The values on which any operator works is called operands. Operator that works upon single operand is called unary operator, while that works on two operands is called binary operator. Java also provides ternary operator that works upon three operands at a time. Now let's see what condition. A condition is an expression composed of operands and completion operator. For example, A is greater than or equal to 15 is a condition. Conditions are evaluated using program control construct. Okay, we will discuss about this in the next video. Now, logical operators. Logical operators help in evaluating more than one condition. Means if you want to compare two or more conditions, then you have to use any of these logical operators like AND or NOT. Many times we need to convert a value from one type to other in our program. Java provides inbuilt classes for such conversion. Remember public static void main in bracket string str. Here arguments passed into main are all string type. That means if you pass numbers as arguments in main, they will be treated as string type. But to perform arithmetic operation on them, we need numbers. So we need to convert string type number representation to their numeric type. Let us see how do we do that for changing an integer class. Java provides an inbuilt class integer which provides conversion method. One such method is parseInt. It takes string type value as an argument and return it in integer form. For example, x equal to integer.parseInt in double quote 50. It means here the 50 is treated as string. We return an integer value 50 in the variable x. Integer class is a part of lang package of Java. So in your Java program, it should be imported as java.lang.integer. If you are practicing Java in BlueJ, it will do that automatically. Let us see the program given here. While running this program, pass value 9 as argument as shown here within double quotes. String 9 will store in str of 0, just the first cell. In the statement integer.parseInt string of 0, value of str0 that is 9 is passed into parseInt, which converts string 9 to integer 9 and return it. Integer 9 is assigned to the variable x, sitting on the left hand side of the assignment operator equal to. Finally, println in next statement is displaying 9 multiplied by 9, that is 81 as a output. So that's all for today. Thank you.